What's going on, everybody? Thank you for taking time to tune in for the return of Hoecially Awkward. We officially kick off the second season with episode 28. Warm welcome to any new listeners, and of course, welcome back to all my loyals out there. If you haven't already, you can make sure to stream all previous episodes on Spreaker, iTunes, Spotify, YouTube, iHeartRadio, wherever you catch your favorite podcast. Hoecially Awkward is available. Make sure you catch us on drop day every Tuesday. What we say, Tom, by 8 a.m.? We're not committing to a time this season. We just going to say by 8 a.m. that motherfucker just going to be up and running.
Just look for it by 10 o'clock. It should be up regardless of where you at.
Okay, so.
Except for Google Play. They be on bullshit.
You know what? I didn't even think about that. That they do the, I know we had to set it up different for Apple Music to be
right.
Able to do
Google
it,
Play, just they post it whenever the fuck they feel like it.
Oh, so Google Play run by niggas.
Yes. Sounds about right.
That's basically what it
That's
is.
That's what it is.
Google Play is on CPT.
Why Google you think Play. I stopped posting like the Apple Google link and just do Spreaker only? Because it's the only one guaranteed to be ready right then and there.
See, and I always post just the Spreaker link straight out. I'm so like, whatever they right have, there. They can listen, you know, wherever they feel like it. But I'm strictly Spreaker with that. Now, if this is your first time joining us, I'd like to properly introduce myself. It's your host and favorite motivational speaker, Mimi or Mimi So 100. If you don't know, I am the
habitual line stepper,
voice of the voiceless,
and supreme in all things unladylike. Now, for my weekly disclaimer, if women using obscene sexual language offends you in any way, then this is where you get off this ride. Thanks for tuning in. Please be blessed.
Stop telling people be blessed. That's bullshit.
It's not.
Yeah, it is.
I do mean it.
Yeah. Right, that's my whole point. When motherfuckers say be blessed, you don't
well,
mean
if,
that shit.
I mean, if you're not able to listen to this shit, then there's something holy about you, so be blessed on your way.
That's like saying, I'm going to pray for you.
Yeah.
No, fuck that. Don't pray for me.
But why I not? Can't.
You're right, you can't.
I think I'm like something like an atheist now. I don't know. I'm at that point now. Man. I crack Jesus jokes, but
Jesus has a sense of humor, though.
He got to. Like, you know, if he were to exist, somebody up there got to be like, you know what? And I feel like if there is actually a God, I can't really be held accountable for the shit that I do because you knew the type of motherfucker you was making when you made me. So how is it my fault? How can I be judged for something that you did?
You do got a point there.
Well, if he exists, he definitely in the bottom of this cup, my guy.
What the fuck?
I kind of feel the same way, though. Like I don't believe in organized religion no more. Like, I'm trying to figure out.
Yeah, I mean, do I feel that there is some, you know.
I feel it is a higher power.
Yeah, I just.
But, yeah.
I'm not into, like, the whole.
I'm on that journey to find.
Hell is right below you.
Now, hell is in her house.
Hey, I get
it. We here already.
So.
When the fuck did everybody become so spiritual? Y'all go get y'all coochies
cleaned. It's been a good year and a half for me.
Spiritual cleansing.
It's been a good year and a half for me, but it's not a lot of like-minded people, so.
Okay, so.
You know, Christians attack you, so I don't bring it up, like.
Well, since we on the subject, I'm going to go around the room, and of course, I'm going to start with Lucky. Now, if you had to describe, like, your ideal God, what would it be like?
Black Jesus.
Black Jesus. So still Jesus, just black.
Just black and ignorant. Black and ignorant. Because, like, he has to sit down and realize, Dad, you do some fucked up shit. He definitely got daddy issues.
I thought you meant the show Black Jesus.
Nah.
I thought he meant the people that seen what that thing smelled like. That was their name.
I believe my Jesus would make songs like that.
Black Jesus remind me of Jay Beezy, though. He definitely remind me of Jason.
He do.
What the fuck?
I'm out.
He do. No, but mine's definitely got daddy issues. So he always, you know, trying to do stuff that's not like his dad and end up being just like his dad.
Okay, Monte.
I just told you. I believe Black Jesus is the people that made the song. What that?
No, what
like.
No, was yo? Nigga.
What was your ideal God?
Be? Jesus.
Yeah.
It don't gotta be necessarily just your ideal God, period. Like, if you chose a God to worship, what would be the ideal God for you to worship?
Like, Odin?
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 Thor daddy?
Yeah, I mean, like, that's my nigga. I like Odin. I would Say Odin, yeah.
Why?
This nigga said Odin. My ideal guy would probably be a pot smoking video game fried chicken eating ass nigga.
So Black Jesus.
So
Monte. I mean, hey.
Nah, you can't be worshiping Monte.
I'm just saying, no, he'll fam. Lead you astray. Like,
imagine if I was Jesus,
fam. It'd be no titties. Want to. Every woman would have perfect titties.
Nobody in heaven can wear a bra.
That's what I'm saying.
That is
like,
heaven.
That is heaven.
So God,
because we didn't see some infinity titties.
Yeah. I'm just saying, like, so
unless infinity titties automatically go to hell.
Perfect.
So we ain't got to worry about infinity titties.
Yeah, and bad titties will get you hell.
Infinity titties?
Yep.
Hey, what if there's an infinity bra?
I don't know.
I need that shit.
I think we hellbound anyway, so it's a barbecue.
Bra? See, like, bra?
Now, I know there's a lot of talk as far as, like, with, you know, what if God was a woman? But to be quite honest, I wouldn't even want God to be a woman. Because I am a woman, and I know how shit can go with that.
Yeah, because I don't want
her. And the last thing I need is...
You don't want her pussy purging?
Like, listen, I'm not trying to have God cop no attitude with me. But, and I forget that it's God, and I'll be like, bitch, square up.
But
I'm
not taking no
then?
Attitude off nobody, not even in the afterlife. So I don't think that I can really handle
well,
God
why
being.
Why does God have to have a woman. Assigned gender?
Right. What if it's both?
A hermaphrodite?
A
hermaphrodite?
But no, I'm just saying why. Like, everybody refers to God in the sense of a human.
Human form.
And that is because you have been conditioned by the Bible.
So you want to worship Aslan.
Image.
Right.
You out here getting your Narnia on is what you're saying.
That's fucking pot talking.
What the fuck?
Well, see, that's what I'm just saying. Like, if that's the case and we made in God's image, how you going to be mad at me and try to send me to hell for some shit that you made me do?
The only reason why we adapt to that is because what if God's a cow?
So
God
you,
is everything.
So you mean like what if
that's
fam
my
is,
personal opinion.
Is just like the wind?
God is saying no.
God
the
is everything. God is all
much.
Encompassing. God is whatever you want to
do. Thanos was on bullshit. God be on bullshit.
God
too.
Is Thanos.
Man. So basically, purple? My like
his
how people have
species.
Like how people go in. You know they had the mosque and they had like the like Korean Jesus. Remember Korean Jesus?
Korean Jesus.
It's Korean Jesus, my nigga.
Jesus. I believe Jesus is Korean.
Yeah, was that 21 or 22 Jump Street?
Both.
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 No, the second one was Vietnamese.
Yeah, that's right. Second one, they moved down the block and it was Vietnamese Jesus. Like, why was they posted up in the Asian neighborhood then?
Stop fucking with Korean Jesus.
Korean Jesus, like, that's half of your shit.
My name is Jeff.
I think this episode has already gone astray.
Yeah, pretty much.
Really damn. Okay.
Really damn,
okay.
Dickens. Get back to back what we're to supposed
it.
To be.
The fact that you two are bringing us back on track means this is a whole new season.
Ow.
Ow.
No, but I think, like, my ideal guy is just low-key, chill, and definitely got a dark sense of humor. Like, obviously punishing people for, you know, the major shit, but you're not really tripping off of people smoking weed.
Like Blind Fury.
Eating bacon. Getting
blind
some
fury.
Dick. Like, as God, you understand that people
word.
Need dick. You
can't
say what?
Blind Fury.
Wait, so. Blind Fury. So, wait, so God is a blind furry.
Furry.
I know you mean fury, but you said furry.
I said what I said.
So God is a blind kinky motherfucker, is what you're saying. Yeah, pretty much.
He don't got a hairy coochie. K-E-W.
Hey, what if God is a thick coochie. Bitch?
I was thinking that, like...
Yeah, so, hey, Tamia.
A ratchet one, though.
We just gonna keep it on this side of the room now, because I'm done with you niggas already.
What? We didn't do nothing.
It feels good to be back after a much, much needed break. And extremely thankful for everybody that's been patiently waiting my return. I appreciate y'all. Hope to bring it back even better before this time around. But what's new with everybody, man? We've been gone a while. What, 2 months? 2.5?
Sounds about right.
Roughly.
Like, can you tell that we missed each other?
Yes, we did.
Besides to me, a fucker.
You love me. So you want to give me some new white jeans that fit my smaller Ooh. Frame.
Okay. You ain't thick no more, bitch. Ain't nobody tempted.
I said my smaller frame. I still got hips and coochie.
Ain't nobody tempted.
Auntie.
Duh, shut up.
What's wrong with y'all? She was lying. She just told me to come sit on her dick.
She ain't got the juice no more, Mimi.
She really is my sister. Something I would have said.
Yeah. I'm trying to behave this evening. Y'all bringing it on me.
Nah, nigga.
After the intro music.
Nah, nigga. We here now.
Okay, well, I know I don't necessarily owe any explanations as to why I needed a break from the show. But as usual, I'm kind of making a choice that may benefit listeners out there. Or even if, you know, it's not you, you may know somebody else that needs to listen to the episode to kind of guide them through it. For so many people, you know, those that are near and dear to me and those that may just see me, you know, clowning around on social media, I'm always seen as the strong one. And I know others have been or currently are in the exact same space that I've been fighting to get out of. So I don't want anyone to feel bad or weak for finally breaking, because that's something that's possible for all of us. You know, like, I don't give a fuck how strong you are. Everybody has a breaking point. And, you know, it takes different circumstances and situations to reach those. Even somebody like me, I've been dealing with major depressive disorder, among other things, for a long time now. And it's a battle. It's a battle I've tried fighting alone a lot longer than I should have. It's a battle that pretty much had me broken, feeling broken beyond repair. Like, just defeated, man. Like, it was only one way out of it. So it's a battle that brought me pretty close to not even being here to talk to y'all about it. Recently I woke up and on the floor in a bathroom stall, a bunch of people that I didn't know, you know, unfamiliar faces. Apparently somebody had alerted security that I was there, and I assume I wasn't responding when they were trying to get my attention. So they crawled underneath the door in order to be able to get me out and get me medical attention. Rushed me to the hospital. I had taken a ton of sleeping pills and started drinking. I just, at that point, I was tired long before those sleeping pills hit. I've been in a really, really, really dark spot, and I haven't been reaching out to anybody to talk to them about it. I only knew one thing at that point, and it was just, I wanted everything to stop. I know people see me, and I'm always the funny one. I've always been the funny one, the one keeping the laughs going, cracking the jokes, and lifting other people's spirits, putting smiles on other people's faces. And I'm always more worried about other people and how they're feeling and making sure that they're not down, and I haven't been taking care of myself. And me neglecting, you know, my own self-care, is, it got me to a very, very, very dangerous point. That only gets you so far. You know, a lot of people deal with pain through laughter. I'm pretty sure, you know, almost everybody in here, you know, can relate to that to some effect or another. But when you're dealing with major depression and anxiety, like, you feel alone no matter what. You can be surrounded by people and still feel like you don't have anybody. And I think one of the biggest pressures for a lot of us feeling like that is we feel like we and our problems are burdens. So that prevents us from reaching out, because we don't want to be, you know, that person that's always bringing the mood down. We don't want to be that person that every time you talk to us, well, what's wrong with you now? What's going on now? Every time I talk to you, you mad or you sad or you upset about something. So that causes us to not really want to talk about things that we should be talking about. in our community, we're feared as looking weak if we can't get through something, or we're not strong if we need help. So, you know, that wasn't my particular case in this situation, but mental health in African American households is not really taken too seriously. We get accused of, you know, oh well, you're not depressed, you're just being lazy, you know what I mean? Like, we don't really get we don't seek the help that we should. So basically I decided to just take some time and try getting the help that I've needed for a long time. That's nothing to be ashamed of. It's nothing anybody needs to beat themselves up about. Sometimes we do so much to convince ourselves that we're okay with our traumas and that our disappointments are okay because we expected them anyway. So, you know, we don't deal with them properly. And after so many years of doing that, shit boils over. People don't realize that no matter what we've quote unquote, you know, gotten through in the past, like, that shit stacks against us. And I've been through a lot publicly that a lot of people know about, and I've also been through a lot of shit privately that they don't. And, you know, that's rough because it's like I'm always one incident away from losing my shit, no matter how minor somebody not in my head may think it is. So, with that being said, I understand that a lot of people are just not equipped to deal with people suffering from mental health issues. Again, I find this particularly true in African American community, because many are quick to tell you, oh well, you know, just pray about it, just pray on it, just pray on it. Like, you don't know if, like, they don't even ask first, like, you know, well, have you prayed about it? They just throw it at you. Like, how do you know I ain't been praying about this same situation for the past 8 months and nothing is, you know, nothing is happening, nothing is working? They just quick to tell you to, you know, get over it, or they'll even go so far as try to top your problems with theirs. Like, oh, you tripping because you lost your job? Well, I did this and I got this and this and this going on. Like, everybody processes things differently. And when you're dealing with depression and, you know, you having all of these different imbalances and things, like, your mind processes things completely, completely different. Another thing is, you know, they'll basically try to guilt people out of depression, not realizing that they're driving them further into it. One of the closest people on this earth did that to me, and I stopped talking to him because I knew what I was trying to get out of. I knew the mind state that I was in. It's not a healthy one. And having someone telling me, oh well, you know, why would you do something like that, you know, that's selfish, and you got your kids and things to think about, not realizing my reasoning was because of my kids, feeling like the state that I'm in, I'm letting them down, and feeling like they would be better off with me not being here. So you can't tell me that I wasn't thinking about my kids when you don't know that was my driving force for me feeling that way. So yeah, a lot of things you really can't control the type of thoughts that you're having, the frequency of those thoughts. So, you know, I encourage anybody that if you are suffering, I want you to make sure that you go out, you seek professional help, make sure you have a solid support system around you. Mine is saving my life right now, sitting around me, and I don't even think they realize it. Psychology Today is an excellent place to look. That's where I actually found my therapist last year. You get a chance to see their qualifications, the different types of insurance and payment options they take. You can actually see the people that you are getting before you even agree to, you know, to set up sessions with them. And that was important for me because, you know, I felt that I would do better getting a therapist that was a Black woman, because there are just certain struggles and issues that I felt would be more relatable for me to discuss with a Black woman than, you know, a white guy or a white woman or even a Black man. But if you need any resources whatsoever for outpatient mental health programs for you or, you know, even somebody else that you know is going through it, you can always hit me up for those. Y'all know I have an open door policy. Whatever you want to know, hit me up. You know, that can always be confidential. You don't have to worry about me putting your business out there. Oh, you know, such and such, she depressed and going through this. She asked me for this. Like, nobody even got to know we had that conversation. Suicide prevention line. I know that's 800-273-TALK. So what is that? Let me, hold on. Sorry, I got to pull up my phone because I'm. So yeah, that is 800-273-8255. Again, that is for the suicide prevention line. And I have a whole list of both inpatient and outpatient resources for anybody dealing with any mental health issues that they want to get worked on. And make sure y'all check on y'all people.
Definitely check on your people.
No, they can't come talk to you. Because you're still healing. This best friend talking.
No, I didn't say come talk to me about their problems.
They can't uncome low shit.
No, I didn't say that. I said come talk to me if they want me to give them resources.
Are you selfish?
I can't deal with other people's shit right now. I know everybody usually comes to me.
Y'all
but
hear the phone number. Do not fucking come talk to her about shit.
Period. She just killed a beautiful moment.
No, that could
can't like, nobody be serious. Like
I was gonna put was some beautiful music behind her.
Bitch made me lose my eyelash over
that
here.
That's, but that's not what I said. I said
look at me and make me.
I said they can come to me for the resources, okay, man.
So I lost the eyelash crying out of one fucking eye. Like, they can't come talk to you about shit and I don't give a fuck.
Like no bullshit. Like I tried to hold this shit in for so long, but I see when she put it on the couch. She looked. Hey, if I look, I'm like, what the fuck is he laughing?
And then she turned. That's what I was like. What's wrong with him? Did she?
Her face is so serious.
Right now she look like that baby doll when the eye gets stuck.
Because I can only see one.
You know, like
I'm crying out of one and mad out the other, because that's my heart.
No, like that's
my like heart. Don't come
right
tell
now.
Her shit.
I literally looked up at the very wrong time. I seen her gently place. She gently placed it on the end of the couch. So I texted her, I'm like, "Fam, did you just?" And then she was like, "It was the thug tears." And it was like, "Okay, this is real sad, but at the same time, I gotta stop looking at the me."
And that's the messed up part. Your support system in this room, we gonna
we
cheer
fucked
you
up
on,
too.
But we fucked up too, and we gonna laugh.
You well, gonna I laugh. Mean, you know, it's. And we all know how my sense of humor is anyway, because I actually got yelled at because I made a joke about it, because Tone told me to go to hell, and I said, well, I tried, and they wasn't ready for me yet, and I got cussed out.
Bitch, you is hell.
So.
Like, we wasn't ready. We wasn't ready.
When I tell you, like.
We wasn't ready.
It was still fresh.
Stressful.
Yeah, it was real fresh, my guy.
Yeah, dog.
You still sitting on the couch fun. Half dead as a motherfucker talking about, I'll try.
I think we I still have my hospital bracelet
like
on.
School shooter and shit.
Yeah, I still have my hospital bracelet on, so maybe
man,
it was
gonna
too soon.
Put you on another 24 watch.
Bitch, still look like a school shooter today, but still.
Well, yeah, you do look like a DC sniper right now.
Man, look.
I don't know
what's
going on. Definitely nope. Stressful. Don't ask her no fucking questions.
Oh, you let it go.
Hey, but that
don't come
a,
unload shit on her.
That was a nice organic.
She is not
no
your savior right now.
And
she's healing herself.
She know.
Told you what she wanted you to know.
So don't be. What was this? What
don't ask it? Me because no I might cuss your ass I'm out.
All right, blood. Don't do it, blood bath.
Blood bath.
Don't do it, blood bath.
Like, I just want y'all to know, like from the bottom of my heart, like. It took everything in me not to laugh.
Duh. Like, hey, because I was like, fam, yeah, why would you laugh?
You can't do shit like that.
It was already hanging, hard. And the bitch made me cry.
But then you looked over at me like that.
Duh, we're turning side to side because you look like two different people when you do that.
Okay, now we not going to act like every time y'all come over here, I don't have a pair of eyelashes on that end table.
Thank you.
I just
looked at that.
But you don't have like a tear coming out your eye and then that motherfucker just peel off and you put it on the other end.
But that's usually how when I get sleepy and I yawn because we do the show late and then my eyes water and then because last time y'all was here he was like, nigga, did you just take your eyelashes off? Because I just peeled them both off and I just
Lord Jesus.
Sam, you done took your hair off, your eyelashes off.
But I gotta take my hair off.
The other
one's
stuck though.
It's fully intact. Like,
that's why I can't take it seriously.
That's why I'm like, bro, okay.
We the complete opposite. Because when I put my right one on, that motherfucker won't go nowhere. But it's something about the left one. It just... that motherfucker like be like, eh, shift over and punch out on me.
I look like one of them Cabbage Patch Dolls. It used to blink.
Dog, I swear you...
No, not Cabbage Patch. Them Dollar Trees.
Them babies with that one eye.
Samantha.
That's just Samantha.
They got a name.
Like, do y'all
Samantha.
Know how hard it is to control your laughter? And it's like...
And he been drinking.
Mimi is back there preaching, and all I can do is look at Tamia like, where the fuck it go?
Man, she was out here dropping some motherfucking knowledge. And your ass over here with one goddamn eyelash.
Oh, it's her fault. It ain't my fault.
Well,
you. It's
see,
this bitch fault.
Okay, so Tamia asked me why I went and put my hat on. And honestly, I put
that's
my hat on
why,
so I can use my brim,
bitch.
So I can pull my brim down and not look at nobody while I was talking. So yeah, that's why I went.
Because if you would have looked up, that whole mom would have been.
Yeah,
we would have had to do a retake. We all would have been in here crying.
Yeah, so that's why I went.
We all gangsters right now.
Y'all seen me cry in the middle of a club, so y'all.
You cry in the middle of the club.
Mind your fucking drunk.
You wasn't there.
I probably
was
drunk.
Mixed.
I'm pretty sure it was.
But I definitely want to give it up to Scooby-Doo and the gang. Because these motherfuckers, woo!
You would have got away with it if it wasn't for these
meddling kids.
Meddling kids! We was meddling kids like motherfuckers.
Jumped in the mystery van on that ass.
We legit jumped in the mystery van
and
rolled
definitely
out.
Went
hey, no, check this out, though. Everywhere we thought she could have been,
she was at. We was just seconds from
literally.
Her.
Literally.
Yeah. So, my nigga, you was just like late. On the crown, you know, like when they be trying to catch Carmen.
I was
San
like Carmen
Diego.
San Diego.
She was one step ahead.
That's literally how it was. Like,
Mimi
like
San Diego.
But just so we clear, when y'all put up posts talking about check on your strong fans, we don't put up posts. We actually
get
up
do
and go
it.
Check.
And then
check
we come, then we cuss her out when we find you.
You know, after we make sure you all right, then you
nope.
go catch this fact.
I ain't let nobody cuss her out.
No,
until.
We didn't cuss her out for real.
Nah,
Some time went by.
But we still didn't cuss her out.
Yeah, we still haven't.
I didn't, because I know how
yeah,
it is.
Me too.
It's rough.
Y'all gave me space for a minute.
Yeah.
No, but
I mean, I did get the, you know, I got the Ike Turner, though. Like,
yeah, if you die, bitch, I kill you?
Yeah
definitely.
Bitch, mm-hmm. I kill you.
Yeah, I got that mm-hmm. a couple times.
Yeah, I know
kill
it came
you dead,
from her.
Bitch, I kill you.
I definitely know it came from her.
Yeah, you would have got fucked up, just so you know.
To me, it came to Pato dressed like
we
Ninja Warrior and shit.
To come and find
I was ready to fight. I came up there with my Vaseline and my tennis shoes and all
Vaseline.
Black.
She's about to get jumped on.
I was about to fight her.
She was put in a headlock.
Found her and then the doctor called me and shit like, hey, yeah, so we got to take it. Motherfucker, I'm in the motherfucking waiting room. Let me in. So, I mean, we definitely did our thing. As a group,
it's nice to know you didn't check out. Because if you
I still got work to do, apparently.
If you would have checked out, then fam would have been on the next elevator down. No bullshit.
Oh, he was getting fucked up.
Yeah, he was pissed.
Yeah.
He would have been on the next elevator down.
Yeah, and y'all know Juan not a violent dude, so when he like.
I'm like,
but whenever, but when
and he got the big ass hands, he could just choke somebody.
I was ready to go to jail. That is the quickest way to see him turn the fuck up. I had your alibi ready.
I got the cuz on deck already. I know who to call when it's time to do.
I would have had your alibi.
Well, anyway, now that you know, I got the tearjerker shit out of the way. I got to get back to my old shit.
Jerker.
Because I need to lift the mood. I'm sorry. Everybody in here drinking wine and shit. And, you know, wine usually get niggas emotional. But
I'm ready to fight.
We have definitely got to talk about
Lil Jon for you.
Mr. Empire facing time for orchestrating an attack against himself that he states was a hate crime.
Yeah, he hated himself.
Like, okay, now I'm not one to jump right out the gate and just call anybody other than Rich a liar. Because, you know, other people deserve chances.
Wait, we still taking shots at Empire?
She's just going pew, pew. That was a 22.
Right. Y'all didn't catch that.
I'm just saying. So I held off initially, even though from jump shit just was not, it wasn't sounding right. To me, it wasn't for me to, you know, just out the gate start questioning shit. But I don't get how, like, these anti-gay nigger hating bigots just
get off on that shit.
Just no, not even that. Like, of all of the TV shows, now, you know, Empire is black cast, right? So these niggas just sitting up watching Empire to recognize them, like, hey, look, they got a nigga from, you know, that all black TV show, and we finna whoop his ass. Now, a week after you get this so-called hate letter in the mail, these people just randomly run up on you going to sub, because he got to Chicago that same day, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Same day.
Yeah, so this same day that you get here and you go and get this sandwich at 2 o'clock in the morning, you just so happen below. You just so happen to run into
Subway. Ain't even that good, my nigga.
Subway, man, Subway nasty as fuck. And what's Subway open at 2 a.m.?
No, actually, it's plenty. They 24 hours went there. So we verified it.
That's bullshit.
But we verified. My thing is, like, cousins 24 hours.
My God,
yeah, cousins.
You went to go get a Subway sandwich, which first of all is trash.
It was probably the tuna one.
At 2 o'clock in the fucking morning. Nah,
he don't like tuna.
First of all, if I'm rich as a motherfucker, I'm sending a nigga to go get my food.
Shit for me.
So that was already suspect.
First of all, it ain't even that he rich as a motherfucker, but if I got a job, I'm calling Uber Eats. Why the fuck are you going down to -50?
Now, too much money. Chicago, now, see, now initially, I was thinking, but I'm like, okay, it was 2 a.m., and I think they cut off time. It was probably like midnight or something. So that option probably wasn't available. But I'm pretty sure.
DoorDash.
I'm pretty sure that there was some sort of delivery option available.
Hell, hotel was probably still was making like
the
food.
Hotel you he stayed in would go get him food if
for
he
for Subway at 2 o'clock in the morning, and you just so happened to run into these niggas at the right moment that hate blacks and gays and recognize you from TV, and they just so happen to have a noose and some bleach.
That's what I'm saying. Have you ever seen the rides around with this?
Walk around with nooses
and bleach and shit.
Now, on top of that shit, I had to just, Bad Boys. I'm sorry. Y'all know I relate everything to movies. But on top of that shit, you paid these niggas with a check. Now, the brothers, both literally and, you know, but they were spotted. Like, they got the video surveillance of these niggas purchasing all of the items used in this attack.
Don't forget, both brothers.
I got two red, two big, sexy ass, like, Nigerians. All in a, my so brother, just, do you have rope to make a noose?
I need red mask too.
So in the middle of this, y'all gonna stop going?
I had to eat my fufu.
I need
in my red mask.
Do you have gloves, my brother?
But all of this started because you felt like you wasn't making enough money. But now, because of, you know, the case and litigation and whatever going on,
you ain't making none.
They pulling
of
you're right. So the last two,
they officially fired him.
Yeah, they ain't official yet. They dumbed his role down and then basically wrote him out for the last two.
So he gonna be in that casket.
Yeah, so the last two.
I watched the news before I got here. They said he was fired.
Yeah, the last two episodes of this season, they scrapped his episode.
Okay, so wait. So let me get this right.
He had like 9 single scenes and they dropped him down.
Because this last season was mostly about him.
Yeah.
So if I want a raise, I should stage an attack and then tell my boss that I need more money.
How does that?
Now, I almost fell outside the building.
Okay.
Because. I shouldn't say that.
Okay. Now this is what I'm not understanding. So
you was a -5 below, my nigga.
So because you feel like
subway.
Because you feel like you wasn't making enough money, you go ahead and you set up this attack or whatever. My thing is, I don't know how you feel like that would ain't the creator of Empire gay? Yeah. If that wasn't enough for him to give you favoritism to give you a raise, you getting your ass whipped, I don't think would do it.
So what me and Juan came to the conclusion was he tried to Terrence Howard the situation to Terrence
basically,
Howard.
Basically, man.
Because we all know that Terrence Howard got booted off of Iron Man because he thought he should be getting paid what Tony was getting paid.
So, he did.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
In the first Iron Man, he made way more money than Tony did.
But I guess Tony made more by the second one. They was like, fuck you. You know, we can, you can be replaced.
Don Cheadle was a very suitable replacement.
Right. I can't see Terrence doing that anymore. So Jamal felt like, okay, I'm basically the centerpiece of this show. I'm the gay token person on this show.
True.
I should be getting paid just as much as Lucius and Cookie.
Now we got to deal with Hakeem, old whiny ass, now for this last season.
Nah, they're just going to bring in a new
and
guy.
The crazy part, like, I'm not even.
I don't got to deal with
I've
shit
never
I don't
seen,
watch that bullshit.
Yeah, well, I've never seen the episode of Empire.
Like, better show.
If he feel like, okay, they salary is better than mine, then I can understand a problem because he is one of the main
centerpiece.
But they made him, but think about this is Terrence Howard and Taraji, they got a track record Jamal can only dream that he can be on.
True.
So you can't expect to be getting the
That's like saying let me make more money than them, but I damn sure better be making more money than Hakeem and Andre mental ass.
And he might be making more than him, but he feel like he needs to be up there.
Neck and neck,
because it's like on this particular show.
I agree.
Yes, you may be, you know, hot shit, but compared to the actual acting resume of things,
right?
They're paying for the star.
Right, I was just
you may
that.
Be a star of was, this show, but you are not
a star.
You know?
Because, bro, you I was an like alien Terrence covenant
Howard
and we forgot.
And Taraji was the selling point of the show.
It was.
So
it's true, because you, nobody remember him being a Mighty Duck and all of that.
Right, that's what I'm saying. Like, you
a Mighty Duck. I remember him on their show.
The Smilers.
Middle Smilers had the show.
That's the only thing I remember him
that
from.
That was all 19 of them.
Yeah, right, like you only flourish
a lot of them. They family,
but whenever I off these names,
but even with Empire being out, when I hear that last name, who do I think about?
Cookie.
I think of the girl.
When I hear that last
Journey.
Name,
I think about
I
the
think
girl.
Of Journey.
Yeah,
Journey.
Yeah.
The reason why my daughter's name is Journey.
Yeah, so that's who I think about.
Journey
I don't think
blood.
About him.
Yeah, she was fine as a bitch in Robot.
Hey, Journey played on a lot
of my Cosby shit. I don't know her from nothing else.
Hell, I even
she played a great debater.
There's a little brother.
She played
Full House.
Yes.
See, she was
my Michelle best friend.
Yeah, she was Michelle friend.
Okay.
She was also a tour guide.
She got
like
AIDS
my
in that one movie,
Ease by You.
That's my main one.
That was her
Ease
fault,
by
though.
You.
That's
Fighting
my main
the
one.
Temptations.
That was a character's fault
the little
getting AIDS in that movie, though. Yeah,
she cheated on her husband.
She played on a lot of stuff.
Cheated
what movie she cheated and got AIDS?
It's called Temptations.
Temptations.
I ain't never seen it.
You need to say it's good. It's pretty good.
She started fucking off on her husband.
Nigga, is you eating sunflower seeds?
And she ended up with
that's
the clap.
Punk ass
fan,
then.
But fan was trying to get his life together.
That's a standing ovation.
That
what the fuck you mean?
But it's just, I mean, there was no other.
Yeah, that's the end all be all. You get AIDS.
Right.
Like, okay,
and
so.
He was still her pharmacist.
When he felt that he wasn't getting paid enough and he staged this attack, like, would you go try to workers comp it? Like, what was your plan?
What was the end game?
I think he had an album dropped.
That's what I need to know.
Because he called himself the gay Tupac.
He had an album out already.
I mean, the original
I think
Tupac.
He had
Tupac really got
himself.
Shot. He had a hit him up coming out. Who the fuck was he going to hit him up again?
Tupac really got shot.
He did drop a diss record. No, real fucking talk. He has a diss song out dissing Trump.
He better go on.
That motherfucker just
gonna
ride up on the
track. Fucking serious.
Pew, pew,
yeah,
pew.
He probably is trying to get his
pew.
Album sales up.
But why are we held so accountable and not the other motherfuckers?
What you mean?
Who's the other motherfuckers?
I just want
Barbecue Patty, whatever the fuck her name is.
Barbecue Patty.
White folks that call the
that's
police.
True.
Lemonade Stan Linda.
Because it didn't take them no time to really just build the case against Dog. That was like.
Right.
Because once
we
they got the Nigerians.
These kids missing from Chicago, getting snatched up in sex trafficking and shit. But y'all find a fucking video of him lying and shit in 48 hours.
They turned them videos up, R. Kelly.
You know Chicago got cameras on every fucking corner.
Oh,
he is
now.
He is now.
That nigga going down.
They was not fucking with R. Kelly. They left dog.
Right.
Because he had a... Hey, real shit.
I don't get how people's getting snatched their wings. I live in fucking Wisconsin. You can mail me a ticket to say that I ran a red light in Chicago.
But right.
But you can't find the motherfucker that snatched this child up.
Like with the pregnant male lady. They never found her.
Never. That's they still haven't found her.
That's some bullshit. Somebody.
But they found the video of Jesse Smollett.
Of just like Smollett. Right.
Getting hit.
Like, why was y'all even putting that much energy into it?
Thank
and
you.
And it's whole
like, the shit is just fishy to me that Chicago police missing. Is just so adamant about finding out his story.
Hey, I'm going to keep
that
it.
That he's lying.
I'm going to keep it funny.
Like, what the fuck is really going
they
on?
They zeroed in on that nigga.
They couldn't
meanwhile.
Believe it.
Just like the Patriots owner.
Yeah.
Oh, all of a sudden, he got some fucking sex trafficking, buying prostitutes. Because he hang around all these black folks.
Man, you can't
he
even,
talking to Kaepernick
you can't
about
even,
coming to his team.
You can't even get no
that's
head out
was.
Here, man.
They
want
him on his
what
team.
The fuck?
You can't even get no head out here, man. That's a sad.
Sad, bro.
Can't even buy no ass.
Yeah,
all of a sudden.
Like
all these years, he done won all these championships. He got at least 10 of them.
He trying to buy the NFL, that's why.
Nah.
NBC.
Kaepernick won his case.
Oh, yeah, that's the standard out. You buy NBC. Yeah.
No, Kaepernick won his case. Yep. And he was talking to him about coming to the
yep.
team.
Yep, give him that paper.
Yeah, he needs somebody to replace Tom Brady.
And now all of a sudden.
I'll tell you this. If Jesse.
Well, it ain't no scandal.
It ain't even been a week.
All old ass rich niggas buy pussy.
Buy pussy.
Fact.
His girlfriend 39. He like 77.
Exactly.
We didn't see this coming.
Hell, I personally wish I knew a few.
Man, I wish I was selling that coochie to him. I have
Do
him backstroking.
Honestly, I wouldn't mind that. Just remember who your friend is.
Yeah, that's all I'm
remember
saying.
That old, remember that old freaky white nigga in striptease with all that Vaseline on his body? Nigga said, I can feel it squishy between my toes.
But no, like this, like, I
don't know. You freaky as a bitch.
Like, they
need a twofer.
No time. They like, let's get dude the fuck up on out of here.
Threefer.
But like, the article that I read this morning, they
I don't
like,
know, they be old. They can't handle, they heart can't handle all that shit.
One on the face, two
he
on the waist.
Straight to the Empire set type shit. And like, they basically was like, what you doing here? Like,
right.
Y'all went and apologized to the whole cast of Empire. And for what's being said, they was
mad.
Hey, like, what the fuck
that's
you?
Some weak ass shit.
If yeah, that's some weak ass shit.
If Jesse Smollett had a hit song on the radio, we would not give a fuck about this.
But you know what's funny?
But he ain't got no hits.
His first song on Empire was called Tell the Truth. That's some funny shit. That like the irony.
Well, he definitely ain't telling the truth, old lying ass yeah, nigga.
Get his
this
ass
just
up
shows we are here.
Well, while we on the subject of Chicago and the name has already been brought up, of course, you know, R. Kelly is back in the news with 10 counts of sexual abuse.
10?
With a warrant issued for his arrest.
Now. Perfect 10.
Dog.
10?
He got to turn himself 10. In by tonight.
Shit, the new evidence presented was apparently a videotape of a sexual encounter with a 14-year-old girl.
Yeah. He
that included vaginal, oral, anal, and of course,
and
urination. Like, why are you still? Why are
why you still pissing on bitches?
Talking
you
about, I'm finna tear
finish?
This 14-year-old poochie up. Who the fuck says
Who
that?
Says that?
Well, and then
he said that.
In the
yeah,
video,
on the,
they
on the
said
video,
he said
they
that.
They said that him and her referred to her 14-year-old pussy multiple times on this tape.
Yes.
Her too, and she
multiple times
was told to call him daddy, and apparently he told her to pee, and then he peed on her.
My God, like,
and
they, they released the image from the video. I passed that around the room.
No, you will not.
No, it's,
oh no,
it ain't naked.
I'm not ready. No.
I will not be a party to child pornography.
Yeah, no, I just say he not. It's just him.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Like
that's
his face.
Crazy. When I was 14, I wouldn't refer.
It's not
to
surprising, but the shit just shocked the fuck out.
Okay,
of
me. Here's my thing. R. Kelly is a grown ass man who drink Hennessy. Do y'all know what piss smell like with that? Hennessy in it? That shit's deadly.
That's definitely the fuck the Pied Piper. Ain't
can
no denying
can we
that.
Not call him
the M.H. and Pied Piper.
He's the Pied Piper.
It
he's
fits,
little.
It
but
fits.
No, like that's out when he village. Made his best hits. Like,
we gotta separate the music
bullshit.
From the man.
Nah. Hey. He was making hits before Pied Piper.
But no, it's, but I'm
I
saying,
can't,
oh, no,
I can't separate
her.
The music from the man.
When he started making hits for everybody else and shit.
It's too hard to separate the music from the man.
The man.
For me personally.
I
but
just,
yeah, you have to understand,
yeah,
R. Kelly's music was
his genius.
The soundtrack of a lot of our lives.
Childhood, yes.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
You can, that's like hear R. Kelly's Jodeci from us.
Exactly. You can hear R. Kelly sung and know what you was doing the first time.
Well, Jodeci was on crack. Was
right.
And they still might be, but that's okay.
I just can't when he come on now. I can't vibe with it.
It makes me cringe.
It irritates me so bad because he got some motherfucking hits.
Yes.
This nigga got some hits.
We went to see him in when I'm controlling
the radio.
That was one of my first
concerts, different. So like if it comes like a shuffle or whatever and he come like I can change it and it don't bother me. But it's like when I'm around other people. It's like, they just let shit, like, the day after the whole Surviving R. Kelly came on, like, your cousin went and she played a whole fucking playlist.
Who, my cousin?
Yes. Yeah, we was
and
in,
I had to work, and I just had to listen to it because
we was in Dale.
She
maybe
went,
that was
same thing. Somebody went on the jukebox
she
and
went
played
directly
all
to
R.
it
R. Kelly.
And just went I mean, and played, and I'm like, and I just, though. I couldn't,
no,
it was throwing me off.
Out of spite, because on a regular night, you're not playing all R. Kelly.
But yeah, my thing
now,
is
I'm
this,
I'm just saying,
for the
there
people
are
who
certain
are,
songs that I still want to listen to.
Yeah,
I want to listen to all the
I
want to
hear Feeling on Your Booty.
Right, like. Laundromat, like right. Laundromat was my shit. It was
see,
like,
and that's the crazy thing. Now I'm at the point where, like, well, can
but
we still listen to?
I asked that on Facebook.
That he wrote.
No,
we can't get rid of all that he wrote.
And that was my thing.
I can't listen to his voice.
I don't want to hear his voice.
Like,
right? And
like,
I don't want to hear your voice singing about nothing.
I was listening.
Now
I'm thinking you with a child, right?
Like I can't.
You know what's funny?
All the shit with the grown bitches being locked up.
Right.
Some of that is like.
See,
I'm sorry.
It's very hard to listen
shit,
to Marcus
the fact
Houston
that you,
now.
Like, I sympathize with you, but the kids,
that shit beyond me, big
you
dog.
Know what, Juan? That might be the worst part.
What?
Some people's careers wouldn't be shit
without R. Kelly.
A whole you lot. Right,
Marcus
a
Houston ain't
lot.
Shit without
B2K
R. Kelly.
Not B2K, be, there would not be no Mr. Motherfucking Biggs. No
he wrote Bump, Bump, Bump.
He wrote most of that second album.
But here's
Girlfriend,
the thing, though.
Yes, he wrote it all.
He revitalized careers.
Clubbing for Marcus Houston, that was a jam.
Hey, yeah. Every time he say M.H. and Pied Piper, I just cringe because it's R. Kelly saying
like,
it.
And you know, like, he got that signature sound, too.
But then,
so when
and then
you hear
listen,
that flute, you like, damn.
Here's the thing.
I can't listen
this is
to
what
this.
People don't understand. R. Kelly has a song that is very near and dear to my heart. It's
canceled.
It's a.
Is this Step in the Name of Love?
No, it has a whole. It was because I was going through a particular point in my life. And
you are not
me.
Alone.
No, trading my life.
I am here for you.
That song gives me like a spiritual healing, and now I can't even listen to it because it's like, nigga, you should have been trading your life.
Heaven, mm. I need a hug. It's like,
no,
what the fuck are
that,
you
that was more of a
like
confessional. That. But that trade in my life, that motherfucking song right there, boy, it speaks to my soul. And look
hey,
who it had to be written.
He wrote In Those Jeans.
He's sick.
But
he wrote Genuine In Those Jeans.
Yes!
I'm
yes.
never
I
stopped
think,
listening to that.
Yes!
I'm going to be real about it.
I think the funniest thing about black people to me when it comes to R. Kelly's situation and not being able to, you know, like, well, I'm still going to listen to him because of whatever, whatever. But
okay,
how
fine.
Many? But how many times have... We see, especially with black men, like if they got any kind of hint of somebody being gay or anything else,
they shut them down.
They cancel them niggas quick.
Cancel
but
the
you,
fuck out.
But you can't cancel
this pedophile ass nigga that
right.
might rape your daughter and take her away from you.
But let
y'all
them feel like somebody
shit.
Gay or come out or something like that. Like Frank
but
Ocean
the black,
was cool.
You know what? Here's
yeah.
the thing.
But as soon as motherfuckers found out that thinking about you was a gay dude,
it's been a lot of niggas.
But people, here's my thing, though.
I still fuck with that Frank Ocean song, even though
he
was singing about it.
But you don't. But you don't. You also don't be on that homophobic shit either. To the point, like, no, I ain't fucking with whatever.
Because you know, because I'm Luther Vandross was fire, and we all know.
We all know.
But he was an old school gay. He didn't put his business out there like that.
But you know what? I'm never going to stop listening to that. Superstar is my shit.
Man,
long ago.
We not doing that.
Yes, right. We are. We just said we having a sing-along. Okay. No. But no, my thing is this. What's really killing me is all the grown women that's like.
It's the women worse than the men.
If I was 14, I would be fucking R. Kelly too.
We understand that. Because you're young and naive.
Exactly. At 14,
you don't understand how sick this shit
but
is.
As a 30, 40 year old woman, bitch, if you don't quit playing
that
my mother.
Because you
pay.
Don't want that shit to happen to your daughter.
And if
a
you
lot
do,
of these bitches don't care, though, if it's a payday.
You're right.
Bitches sell their kids.
Assholes.
Yeah.
Bitches do it every motherfucking day.
I didn't unfriend a few of you hoes. Hey, bitches.
I just want to know why these hoes ain't got no crazy cousin. Because I would have been with the shits. Like, I'd have pulled up on Mr.
But Kansas. You got to understand the manipulation of a child. Making that child feel like she number one, she important.
I don't give a fuck who you make. You not hanging with my cousin, bro.
That's a lot of people don't have that.
I would have pulled up. I'd have been at every R. Kelly show like, my guy, you got to come see me. You finna get all of the fade. I'll fuck you up. I'll fuck security up. I'll shoot this motherfucker up.
Imagine how many little girls that didn't know, just like the one girl that was in the sex videos, that stole the sex videos. She was adopted. She didn't have no family. He knew what to do, what to say.
Yeah, he was definitely
to these little girls.
He was definitely.
He's sick from his own trauma. He's sick.
I hope they rape him. And that's probably
like
some
I sympathize with him.
I mean, you.
But I sympathize more with them.
Yeah, it's one of those things where like hurt people. I don't really want to jump into this because we done been there and done that for the last couple of weeks, but like. Motherfuckers really be sick out here, like, and you just have no idea how sick they
Munchausers.
Are. Like,
they really do be.
We ain't done it here in the past couple of weeks because I've been gone for 2.5 months.
Well, like, shit like kleptomania. Like,
right.
That shit
like,
is a they sickness. Really,
like, it's easier for us to say, you know, why they just don't stop? Why they don't just do this? They can't.
It's
shit.
It's,
yeah.
Yeah,
like, just like crackheads, it's just like that. Like it's a chemical imbalance.
Well, Mr. Sylvester Kelly would have been fucked up on my watch. I'll go fuck how much money you got if I catch you.
But you know what? A lot
I'm
of people
pulling up on you with the
him.
Smoke.
Scared because he got that clout, and we always say what we won't do in a situation until that shit happened to us.
Until that money in your face, and you be like,
money.
Shit.
It can
I'm
be
depending
abuse,
on this money
all
from
type
this
of
nigga.
Shit. You can be like, oh, she be always getting her ass whooped. I could never be that until you in that situation.
And you know
until your
that's a huge
that's,
thing that's been going on my news
feed. Yeah, that's definitely something that we've been talking about amongst ourselves in the group, like domestic violence, like because we seen that shit firsthand. Like it's a friend of mine on Facebook. Like she posted the
it's
picture
a couple.
Of herself. Like her baby daddy fucked her. Up and she like posted the photo like yeah this was me
and motherfuckers don't believe her even it with the evidence
but you know what it wasn't even that they didn't believe her it was the fact that she went from posting that to posting steak dinners and shit like that with him like Mimi am I lying
but it's
like,
hard for a
we've been
person
talking about that
that's
shit for
been
weeks.
Through it to like, leave
like she even made a status like I need guy friend and like nobody would touch that status like cause they was like what
you
the fuck
be
can
back?
We do
I also feel like...
And that's exactly what she did, Denise.
If I jump out the window for you and I come to your rescue one time, you gotta
that's
be...
That's a one time.
No, I'm just saying, like, if you want out, you gotta be willing to get the
but
help.
It's not exactly. That easy.
No, I know it's
no,
not.
No,
but
not
I understand what
I just don't
want to
keep
like,
jumping.
I'm not gonna keep
like,
risking
you
my life
to, like, if
and my freedom
if he
and you
beating
keep
you
going
up
back.
And you keep calling me like, hey, yo, Juan, he keep hitting me. So every other week, you got me putting hands on this nigga. And I'm beating the shit out of him, but you keep going back. Eventually, I'm going to get to the point where, like, fam, you
right.
Don't really want help.
Yeah.
So don't call me to whoop his ass no
and
more when all you do
and
is
that's
go
that's why
back.
You can't be so
but
quick to get in somebody else's shit.
Like, speaking from seeing my auntie at a very young age getting abused by her son and father, I was always like, I'll never, ever do that shit.
Right.
Never, ever. But I have been through that shit. Not necessarily abuse me and the nigga was going at it.
I'm
going to tase his ass.
I'm
going to fucking pull a butcher on his ass. I'm going to pull your own gun on
your
ass. But I've been through that shit.
Well, don't call me to fight him. Call me and say, hey, bro.
I didn't call nobody. I had niggas that would put him under the dirt. My own baby daddy wanted to put him under the dirt.
Well, see, and I think that like that's the difference as far as what Juan's saying. Like, don't keep calling me. When you call me for this
you,
needs to be a one and done.
Right, because you know what
call
I'm on.
Call me
when
you're done.
But you know, out of all people, when you in that vulnerable state, you need somebody to talk to. that may be that person. You can talk to him.
You can talk to a motherfucker all day, but at the same time.
Well, talking to him versus telling them to come to your aid is two different things, though.
Right.
That's venting versus, hey, I need you to come flip this
nigga. Because at that moment, you feeling like, I'm done. I'm sick of this shit.
And that was the thing to me, because it was like, she posted the picture. She was like, I went to the police. The police not really going to do shit. They ain't going to do nothing but let them out. And I'm like, I hit all of them up. I'm like, hey, y'all, how should we go up? Like, should I be a friend to her?
Because a young lady just lost her life within the past couple of weeks.
An older lady and a younger lady. One of the girls we went to school with, she's a friend of ours. Mama, boyfriend killed her.
Yep.
Yeah. Same shit.
Yeah, because this was just.
Was that porn?
No. It was definitely porn. To get his life 80s porn. Harry Bush.
But she called, him arrested. He posted bond.
She called her daddy and the police.
Yep.
He stabbed the daddy, beat the daddy up, and killed her.
Yeah.
Like, I went through that shit. Me and the nigga was fighting cats and dogs all through the house, and Mimi don't know that she fucking saved me. Just the shit that she went through just recently, I was going through at that time. We was on Twitter before I ever got pregnant. I was going through that shit, fighting every night, threatening to cut this nigga throat from ear to ear, pulling pistols out on him, tasing him. He ain't give a fuck.
Personally, but this bitch, if you tase her me laughter, once I'm out,
on my life, talking to me, don't do it.
Like, save me. I got to a point where I was like, I'm sick of this shit. All my guy friends moved my shit out of my house in 4 hours. 4 hours.
But what happened after that, though?
I left the nigga alone. He still come back trying to.
No, but I'm saying that was your.
That was my breaking point.
When you called them to come and they came.
The man everything I was just with, he paid for everybody to move my shit. Because I told him what the fuck was going on. That was my breaking point.
But you
like,
see,
I'm sick
like,
of this shit.
But you
I'm going to end up in jail killing this nigga.
But that was
or
it
he going to kill
right,
me.
But that was it
but
for
once you
that
made that
it.
Phone call to your homies, whether they was going to whoop
but
ass
everybody,
or move
what
shit.
What I'm you saying is everybody is not as strong as other people. Like, you can say.
Right.
What I won't do in this situation, what I would do in this situation, but you don't know until you're actually in that situation.
That's facts.
Well, just call me for moral support, and I'll talk you through whatever you want.
Why are you a lie?
I'm saying I'm gonna talk to you, fam. Like I just said, don't
but that's
have
just
me over
though.
There
I'm
beating
just
his
like
ass.
Tamika,
and all you want to do is
I'm
help patch up his wound.
I always tell y'all I'm okay,
but guess what? You can't call Juan for a ride.
Hold on, don't do my nigga. He got a car.
I don't need one for a ride. Bro. I got my own ride.
My nigga got a car.
It don't matter if you can't
he
drive it.
He got a car. He just don't drive it. He been had a car for years, right? But
he was going to get there anyway because he was going
to
call the... He was going
to
call the goon that's trying to get them cookies
when
anyway.
When I was talking to him at Potawatomi, Juan was ready to go. I'm like, Juan, calm down.
He was going
to
hop in the whip.
I was definitely finna leave work.
He was pissed. I'm like, Juan.
I was definitely finna leave work.
Juan is the person. Juan one of them old cool calm niggas. He ain't gonna.
We
talk.
How many times
he
called Juan
told,
a serial
though?
Yeah,
how
the, he the last line
often
of
do we call him a serial killer? When
I,
we say
he
that he could be
Juan is the Juan is a serial killer.
He really gonna be that one.
Juan is the nigga
gone.
Who gonna be choking you and
it's,
talking like this.
It's certain people.
Hey, Juan gonna choke you and he gonna be like, I told you,
I can't breathe
to leave.
I'm just saying.
Now you made me do this to you.
It's certain people.
I didn't want to do this.
Now I know you. You can hear me because I see your eyes rolling back. You still with
gonna be calm as
you
a bitch.
Little oxygen left.
Choking that shit.
This is not funny.
You know, like when Melvin whooped Jody ass and he would start talking to himself. So I told this
nigga
little nigga don't fuck with
two
me.
Strikes
that's
to go back
Juan.
To jail for life.
Juan gonna be like,
man,
all I wanted to do was eat the motherfucking Oreos, and you keep fucking with me.
That's bro all day.
I'm just saying, it's some people that you go there for. And yeah. She one of them people.
And I have plenty of them people.
But I'm the same. Anybody can talk to me about anything.
Yeah.
Just don't have me come busting your nigga in and shit. And
I
then
said
that,
what I said.
And now, when,
come,
and now whenever I come
else.
Over. And now whenever I come
yeah,
over,
yeah,
this nigga want to poison
that's
my mind.
That's exactly what I told Mimi and them. I'm like, I kind of want to be like, you good? But I'm like, we know how this story goes. You don't really... kind of voluntarily. Like, it sucks, but that's
and the
just
thing
the way
is, you have to let people know when you for real ready, right, that I'm here.
Because that's exactly what happened. I told them.
I can't say that because I'm the type of person, if you call me and be like, this nigga just did whoop de whoop whoop,
I'm coming.
I'm coming. And we're going to fuck him up and you're going to be with him tomorrow. And I'm going to be like, you stupid bitch.
And that
bitch,
was my reason.
But we're going to be cool.
Never saying
and
shit.
Then if you call me
no,
next week, we can do this
but
shit
no,
again.
You, don't, you can't do ain't that no in certain thing situations because some shit ain't no coming back.
I don't want men people to do that, though.
Just like this nigga. If this nigga fuck around and break, oh boy, neck. Ain't no coming back.
Right,
from
I was
going
to say, I know my people. It ain't no coming back after I tell them. Especially
why,
my daddy.
That's why when a girl put
my
that
daddy
shit on
my street connected.
What I tell y'all, I
my
said, damn.
My,
this,
and my
cousin,
like,
nigga, you going missing. Period.
I have one cousin that I will not call unless
the
shit's
ass
real.
Like, literally, unless
that's why
I have
I
no other options.
Like,
and
some, at all these
sometimes
loud
you can't.
And you know what? I
niggas don't
that
be knowing until I get out. And they're like, reckless and danger and safety. What you
exactly
do?
Exactly. Like, when I had my when I had my Twitter squabble, I didn't call none of my people. Like,
the main nigga that was talking shit about, man, niggas just be putting on the show and
like,
want to blah, blah,
when
blah.
When I tell you, like, them niggas jumped on my ass because I didn't say nothing. Like, I didn't tell Mimi and them. I didn't tell Ken. I didn't tell none of them. Nigga.
I didn't
Ken,
tell my mama.
Ken pulled up.
Found out.
I was going to say, Ken pulled up. I didn't call them niggas. I didn't do no distress signal, none of that. I'm like, this is my fight. I got this.
That's and like, because I know. Like,
we family.
Like,
it ain't
that's
no
my
fair
thing.
Fight.
Like, unless, like, for my one particular cousin, Jeremy, I know who I'm talking about. For my one particular cousin, unless the end result is that I want a motherfucker
dead.
I'm not calling him for
that's
shit.
Exactly
I'm
why
not
you
telling
don't.
Him
and
nothing.
That's how I grew up. Like, you bitches listen, gonna fight. It's gonna be 50 years. We gonna fight
y'all.
But
you,
we ain't telling the rest of these motherfuckers.
I can tell you this one time. These
the
dudes
ones you don't tell is
was
the
harassing
ones that
me
will
at
kill
a
them.
It was a group home. I was coming back from red carpet.
Hey, did you forget that you had on like eyeliner or something?
Did I just wipe it across
yeah
my whole
yeah
face?
Yeah.
You look like
I
a warrior.
You out here with
you talking about my leg.
Like, damn, she got on the
right.
She got on the green
it's
arrow right back.
That's a,
you look like Taker.
Like, she like yeah the Indian chief and shit.
That bitch got war.
Y'all was just going to let me be out here alone.
No, I told you as soon
so,
as I saw it.
Like so you Indian ain't got chief? No eyelashes. They she did look like a raccoon.
And I'm over here raccooning.
It's cool.
Oh, great.
Hey, that shit been running out your face.
Hey, tears are hoecially awkward bringing us together. One makeup malfunction at a time.
Dude, look at my
you got fingers war paint on this shit. What the fuck going on in here?
I need some
what
paper
I
towel.
In here like Tatanka.
Right, I'm in here like
yeah, that's
the,
why
what's
I'll be
the
laughing
shit the football players wear on their face?
Yeah. Be laughing y'all at half of these bitches on Facebook that just be talking
they too
shit
tough for
they
me.
They so
it's
fucking
funny,
tough like bitch. You just don't know.
Yeah.
Everybody
I ain't got
no
shit.
Though,
I got some bitches that'll roll up on you and whoop you foot.
The thing is, everybody tough. Like,
right. So
and that's
tough
cool. I'm not even mad at you. I love the love of your confidence.
I don't.
But everybody
don't
tough
like
until
shit
they get their shit split.
Like, bitch, be yourself.
Ain't nobody
no, no,
beyond
some,
getting
some people done got their shit split.
And they
still
talk shit.
Respect, salute. I salute that.
Yeah, you gangsta ass
motherfucker. I do. If you get your ass whooped like
that. I respect
that.
I respect that.
I respect that you get dragged, but you still like... But
no,
you,
you
didn't
got,
get.
You
but he didn't get my cone bread.
Right.
They like the Adrian Broners of Facebook.
Yeah, that Adrian Broner is a motherfucker.
Yeah.
Nah, didn't fam say he was done with this?
He said
boxing
he's done.
Shit?
He's
going
back
to selling
drugs.
No, he said everybody knew. He said everybody knew he
yes
won that fight though.
After this last. And I don't even think he necessarily lost that
he
fight.
Lost,
how everybody? No,
nah,
that was
that
a good ass fight. How everybody was making it seem.
If you're not first, you're last.
Nah, that was a fucking draw. He didn't get his ass whooped like everybody was making it seem. Like, he was fighting the fuck back.
Okay,
he didn't
well,
just get beat the
yeah,
fuck off.
A lot
on
of people fight back and still
hey,
get
their ass
whooped.
Hey, I said I was done cussing.
I saw the highlights.
Please
he didn't do much.
That, it ain't happened in a long time.
So,
I'm trying to be a lady.
This next topic is actually 100% inspired by D. Roscoe because I screenshot it. Her
what
statuses before I shut down
I feel like
my
this
Facebook.
Is set up.
It's not. So stat number one says, so y'all out here selling coochie for $40 for real. Y'all need a union. That can't be the prevailing wage for coochie sellers. This
be
is beyond $40. Me, big fella. Then she says, $40? Shit just blew my prostitution goals. I thought I'd at least be able to get a couple properties from this snatch. Shaking my head. Upstate, I got to wait until the coochie market bounce back, and I might be entirely too old by then. Coochie entropy is a real thing.
$40. But for real, let's
that ain't
let's
even speak too much. Read a picture.
No, okay, but listen, but okay.
That
now,
ain't even a meal. You can't get a meal and
but,
a drink.
But you know what's but you know what's funny? Like, okay, I now for us, obvious for obvious reasons.
I don't like Mexican food.
Selling pussy for $40 sounds very inexpensive and crackish. But I'm gonna flip the coin and say why I think that they may feel that $40 is a justified price. Because
for an hourly worker,
yeah.
They these niggas saying it's $40.
But no, did you see how my friend broke it down on one of those posts?
Saying, I need $40.
I don't know. Yeah, you just
but that's my because $100.
Because okay, look, because most people not making $40 an hour, and most niggas not lasting an hour to fuck, and like even if they do, like it's $40 for that hour. So they may really be looking at it from an hourly wage.
30 minutes.
Like they may really be looking at $40 as an hourly wage.
He like, was like, if you instead get 10 customers a day, that's $400 a day. I'll make $400 a day. Yeah, so I kind of like it might have risked $400 a day.
Customers.
No, 10 that's customers.
A, 10, that's still a lot.
$40 a day. I don't make $400 a day.
Well,
but it might be built like one of my exes.
Is your
or a couple.
Coochie really wore out? Because most niggas probably ain't.
Hey,
the
here's the
anyway.
Here's the reality about coochie.
Fucking friction, carpet burn.
Because the ones buying it probably not. Really?
The more you
buy
use
it,
the better it gets, is what I hear. That's what science says.
The more you use it, what?
But I mean, they're not.
It's a muscle.
They're not designated.
Coochie is a muscle,
right?
So the more you use it, you're working it out.
Yes.
So you keep
right
it.
For you niggas talking about bitches don't got no walls. Your dick ain't big enough for a bitch to have no wall. If she can push out a fucking 8 pound, 10 pound, 6 pound baby and snap back,
but
that dick ain't big enough for a bitch to not have walls.
She
got a big coochie. She had a big coochie from the start.
Here's the problem. The niggas get it backwards. Y'all think the bitches who out here fucking is the ones who ain't got no walls. No, the bitches who ain't out here, the bitches who's prudes, they're suffering from coochie atrophy. Coochie has a use it or lose it policy. If you don't use it, your walls will thin out.
No, they just ain't got no science.
Your walls will thin out and that pussy's going to be trash. That's why y'all be chasing these bitches, these so-called good girls.
Coochie can do what it want to do. Like,
coochie can't. Coochie. But if
it
you
depends
don't
on the woman.
Use it.
So wait, I've been winning this whole time by fucking her.
What the fuck is
my brother? Don't nobody need to be.
And I just
10 minutes.
Don't nobody need to be like fucking
10 minutes. That's a long time.
I'm about to say I don't need all that extra shit.
See, and this is why I'm not ashamed of my shit because I got friends like y'all.
Hell no, 10 minutes. If you fuck me over 10 minutes,
I'm
gonna
be irritated.
Does that include foreplay?
No,
in the 10 minutes.
No, that's just because you're a man.
Y'all men though.
Well, I've been drinking Rossi, so
no, you're
gonna
be holding a cold compress up to my pussy.
But no, you're not about to be busting up and down on me.
Why you gotta say it like that?
She said it so aggressive
for so long. Motherfuckers led you to believe like if the sex was long, then it's bomb.
No, that shit whack. And we sitting there just like
stupid whack
shit. You motherfuckers got the game messed up. Long sex?
We don't want long sex. We want meaningful sex.
Yeah.
So if you gotta eat it,
that's true.
Not too hard.
It depends on who I'm
that
with.
That new meme circulating on Facebook about how
if you got a curve to the back, we can take longs. We might not because, curve to the back.
Well, I've been drinking Rossi, so I got a good 15.
Quick.
You're coming quick. I just feel like.
Yo, do you know how long rumplement sex is?
Oh, my God.
I could imagine.
Keep that henny
same
dick.
I could imagine.
And them pill dicks.
Same
we don't want it.
Okay,
you
so
pop pills.
So anyway, back to pussy salary, because I'm not finna do this time length conversation with y'all. Like,
I
shit strongly
out of bitch
do
off of edible.
Because she mad. She ain't got a coochie. She got a dick.
No, I'm just, my shit is retired.
Let that edible kick in. I struck you something
my
serious.
My shit is retired.
Your shit retired.
It's retired.
Bitch, please.
Mine is.
It's retired.
Mine too.
You done hung
for
it up.
For 2 hours.
But yeah, but like as an hourly wage, they legit might feel like that shit better than going to fucking college. Like it's everything else, of course, is still college bad. But it's like
that's how most chicks pay for college.
Because if you have like an actual salary for the pussy, like it don't matter if they last 2 minutes right. or 2 hours.
Nigga, $40.
Because it's a salary. But like, how exactly do you price pussy for the consumer? Like, especially because you're like you're an independent contractor.
Let me
at
go
that
ask
point.
My ex.
So here's the thing.
As a person that is still on Twitter, I do see prices like per hour, per 30 minutes.
Yeah, because it's like,
$60 for
pussy
1 hour.
On Twitter?
But like, but yes, if, but like, can you
since
write
Tumblr
off
clothes,
like
a lot
condoms
of
and lube and shit is like tax expenses and shit?
Ooh,
like,
Tumblr was my spot
because I mean, it's like it's no flex spending account. Like, if you catch the clapper, you get your ass whipped by a nigga that didn't want to pay at the end. Like, it's no money for bail if
that's why you got to pop up.
Like, you got to plan for that.
But most of these new age pimps don't even be around; they be a phone call. Because
you actually.
Bitch, I already got my ass whooped and shit.
Because you actually got a lot of expenses that come with selling pussy and still being profitable. Like, especially if you renting hotels. Because, hell, that $40, you might break even if you get one of them hotels on Appleton.
They give all their money away to this nigga that's tricking out on the next bitch.
What the fuck? Wait, so you know some pimps is what you're telling me?
I dated one.
Swag?
I don't even want to know.
Sauce? So much sauce right there.
I was a pimp's pimp.
Failure.
Pimp's pimp.
Pimp's pimp. But, okay, pimp. So.
I counted money and I spent that shit.
I like that.
I was that good girl. I'm a good girl. I ain't giving shit away.
Okay, so if you had to put a price on your vagina.
Ain't no price on mine.
No. Come on, man. Let's play hypothetical, fam. Don't do that.
No, I'm doing that.
You see the conversation we have, fam.
Because I know, because niggas from 18 years ago still love it.
They gonna be holding that shit up like Myron was when Diamond walked up and he had that money like.
Yeah. That's just how they act.
Okay, well, since Tamia don't want to play fair. Mimi, if you could put a price on your Dinkin' stuff.
It definitely ain't 40. I'm going to speak for Dinkin' stuff.
Well, ain't nobody asking your overprotective ramen noodle head ass, bro. Relax.
Hey, fuck you, virgin. Get some pussy and realize how much it costs on real coochie.
You know what?
Not the whores you
I thought
fuck
he
with.
Was getting first, some fetal alcohol coochie.
First of all.
Not the whores he fuck with.
Man. First of all, on Hoecially Awkward Season 2, I'm going to let this be known. You gonna keep calling me a virgin,
and we gonna square up.
And you not gonna make it.
You
not gonna make it, my guy.
I was almost proud of that nigga. I thought he was gonna say, "Hey, on season 2, I'm gonna fuck you."
That's what I thought.
I thought he was gonna say,
"You gonna get fucked on season 2."
I would have respected the fuck out.
I was on your side. I was rooting for you.
I
would have respected that.
Say
it. Next subject.
Can y'all tell that we missed each other?
Well,
we did.
Tamia don't want to put a price on her penis, so it's all good.
My coochie dick has no price.
It's a coochie dick?
Because once you go in it, you always love me.
But it's a dick, so how you go?
It's both.
So you're a hermaphrodite.
Somebody else going to put a price on
maybe.
My shit is
so, like, speaking of hermaphrodites,
wait,
like.
What?
That's right.
We were wondering if they can get pregnant.
You just can't transition a conversation with speaking of hermaphrodite.
No, this is a conversation before your late ass got here.
Right, oh, it shit. Was.
Yeah.
Fuck
y'all,
man.
And
you
we
see
just said,
Mimi face like, oh, she just put you on blood.
Yeah,
like, no, man, because we wait, I knew that it was going to come back here. But wondering, like, if they can get pregnant. And then we had a whole conversation on, like, if they got both. Like, it's like, so you got semen and eggs? Like, can you, like knock yourself up? Like, how that go?
We actually don't.
The whole reproductive, or do they have just both organs in one reproductive
Tom,
system?
Pull out Google.
Yeah, usually they may have both organs, or they may have
stop texting
one
them
organ
hoes, Jesse.
One and a reproductive system. Right. But typically, so, none of that shit work.
No sperm.
Right.
So they can't get wet or hard?
Huh?
Right.
So they can't get wet or hard? So
they
just walk around
here like their reproductive system.
They don't have the
work.
Sperm
no,
to
I mean,
make the baby.
But I'm saying, but if they have both.
Do they sometimes have like a coochie that get wet, but they dick don't get hard? Or no, they sometimes get hard, but they can't get wet?
Just Google a picture of a hermaphrodite's anatomy, and then you'll see what I'm talking about.
I've seen watch porn of many big times. Clits.
Oh, okay. Damn.
You ain't seen my pussy. I ain't seen, you know, coochie shots.
You be high.
I'm be high as fuck. Whoop. Have I sent you some coochies? Whoop,
whoop, whoop.
Wait, did you try to get it for like the past couple months? No, FYI. Y'all know y'all best friends. Y'all got to send y'all news first to be like, all right, is this all right, bitch?
Hey.
And then she be like, nope, cover that roll up.
I shouldn't say, hold
do
up.
Do that.
That's not necessarily true.
Hey, I'm just, hey. That Mimi is the new guy. I'm just saying. The next trip, she go come back with a different glow. Don't ask me why.
No, no, we don't have those conversations, Monty. We don't.
What?
I'm not saying that. I'm talking about besties.
Kill it.
Sending each other, so Tone and Juan looked at each other like, don't even think about
it. We had the last session. They was like, nope, nigga, like, don't bro, even do like it.
How these balls look.
They was like, hey, peach they
shiny. These balls
don't
shiny
me
enough.
Nothing.
Like
you missed the gray hair on the bottom.
Now, I feel like the Hoecially Awkward family need a boundary box.
Trying to see if they have patches and shit.
Patches?
Don't go get sugar, y'all.
I know what type.
Don't blast her like that. She was so nice.
No, she's nice. I just feel nice. Like, no, there's
my
no crew.
She looked like a cancer patient.
She's new. She needs more practice.
Yeah,
more practice.
I heard your coochie look like that doll from Toy Story.
It did.
With the
sucker. What was her name? Cindy? Stuff on it and shit. Yeah, she was Angelica as fuck.
Angelica.
Yeah, the Angelica doll. Cynthia.
From Rugrats. Yeah.
Cynthia. That was the name of the doll, right? Cynthia.
Man, that, you know, that's fucked up.
But I don't get none, so it didn't matter at the time.
Yeah, by the time you probably busted
no, I just
open,
went
it
home and fixed
same.
It.
No, he probably just didn't care.
So can we call
he
your vagina patches? Yeah.
You know what?
Old school niggas don't care.
I mean, I'm only 31, but I'd be like, fuck
the sea, fuck them hairs.
So like, to me, you're sitting on my couch, you got her tail in her head and on her coochie.
Nope, she shaved today because I got a little action.
To me, out here looking like Spinderella.
That's right, atta girl.
That's who it was.
She bald
and
soft today.
Salt and pepper hair and wit.
My daddy just told me that. My girl, you look like your mama when she was.
No, about everybody on that.
I know. I looked in the mirror. It was like, Lynette.
To me, it got on them tight ass jeans, Denise.
Now I'm about to go change into some joggers.
I'm over here dressed like a stick up kid, so I ain't got nothing to do with that.
Mimi over here looking like
I'll be
robbing
under the Roxy AKK or not.
That's
all I'm thinking. I don't do shit under the Roxy Act. I ain't even trying to steal nobody, nigga. I don't do nothing under the Roxy Act.
No, keep them niggas.
Now.
Are we talking about that?
Roxy topic has been addressed multiple times. I wasn't around for that. I had nothing to do with it. But
that's not what I heard.
I just want to say that. Not even about her specifically.
Her, he was the ringleader of that shit.
Just period. Y'all have really got to stop laughing and joining in on, you know, all of the other jokes with other people and then taking that shit personal
when
it's your turn.
You.
You really got to stop.
You ain't exempt. What I just tell somebody?
I mean,
like
you
y'all,
mad,
y'all
like,
really,
yo,
really, really, really,
you
know, really gotta
you
stop
really
this.
You really out here stealing, and niggas really cracking jokes because you really steal. So why you
okay,
mad?
Okay, but why you mad?
Because
you know
you
stole. I stole.
But
everybody
knows that jokes are what
Jones
funnier
Hammer?
Than the truth. Whether it's true or not,
sometimes
jokes is gonna be
when they are the truth.
Yeah, but it's like you can't be upset. When jokes are thrown,
right?
Hey, at least you're still flexible.
She trying to bust that thing open
you
over here. You better watch out.
She caught a whole hamstring injury, ACL, about shot like a motherfucker.
You gonna
hey,
cry? You gonna cry in the car?
Cry in the car, nigga. You gonna have to carry her out to that motherfucker.
you got some Victory vodka in this motherfucker? What the fuck?
Might be a baby made from two coochies tonight on Victory.
Lord.
Well, that's all the time we have, folks. Hope you enjoyed listening to this comeback episode of Hoecially Awkward. Looking forward to y'all joining us again next week. Once again, you can catch up on all episodes on Spreaker, iTunes, Spotify, YouTube, iHeartRadio. We everywhere. this is why niggas not invited back. But make sure you catch us every Tuesday by 10 a.m. this season. We want to make sure that everybody gets a chance to listen, even those that use Google Play. But until next time, we gotta go.